It's a big day, isn't it?
今天是一个大的日子。
啊、very busy weekend.
今天这个周末大家都很繁忙。
I guess everybody have a lot of program.
所以今天我想大家都会有很多的安排。
Slowly winding down, get back to normal, so to speak.
然后我们的生活可以渐渐的、回到平常。
All the excitement ceased.
当这个所有的这些、兴奋之情、平变淡的时候，
曲终人散的时候，
曲终人散。
再考考你。Yeah, well, and we need to go back to normal. Okay.
然后我们就要回到一个普通的生活中。
But before that, let's share.God's word and share a message with you.
嗯，那在这个时候，我们还是先来看一下神要跟我们说什么。
Yeah. Let's have a word of prayer.
让我们先一起祷告。
Father God, we thank you.
天父上帝，我们感谢你。
You are a great God.
你是伟大的神。
You sit at throne in control of all things under the sun.
你坐在宝座上，阳光以下一切的事都在你的掌握中。
We thank you
谢谢
that you are in control.
你在控制。
When all the floods on the land, you're in control.
当大水洪水泛滥的时候，你在掌权。
When the sunshine bright and glossy, and you're in control.
当在阳光之下，你在掌权。
We thank you. You are a good God.
你是这样一个好的神。
You have nothing but the best for every one of us.
你为我们每一个人所预备的都是好的。
Help us to come to realize it.
让我们每个人可以认识到。
Help us to know you are a good God.
帮助我们知道你是一个美善的神。
Good indeed.
你是一个真的好的神。
Whatever happened to us in our life,
无论在生活中发生什么，
There's always a purpose behind.
都有它的目的。
It's always good.
也都是好的目的。
You always has good intent for every one of us.
你对我们每个人的心意都是好的。
We thank you, Father.
我们谢谢你，天父。
Help us know you just a little bit more today than yesterday.
让我们今天就比昨天多认识你一点。
In Jesus' name we pray.
以耶稣的名我们祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Happy Father's Day.
大父亲节快乐。
啊。You made it, huh? All right. 好，我们又换中文了哈。
Let's change back to Chinese.
Yeah. 父亲在圣经中是一个非常非常至关重要的角色。
In Bible, father is a very important character.
我们平常看起来 ，Hey, dad, hey, this and do that, but in a lot of In every aspect I can think of, 又讲错了，都很重要哈，爸爸都很重要。
In every aspect I can think of, a father is very, very important.
一个在一个家庭里面，一个父亲如果是一个敬虔的父亲的话
，In a family, the father is a God-loving person.
他的妻子蒙福
，Then his wife will be blessed.
他的孩子蒙福。
His children will be blessed.
他的后代也蒙福。
His descendant will be blessed as well.
都决定于这个一家之主。
It all depends on the household.
所以我们做父亲的
the head of the household.
我们做父亲的一定要晓得一件事情。
Therefore, us who are fathers or fathers to be,
不是什么都是以我为中心。
It's not self-centered.
当我们每一个人就特别做父亲很敬虔在神面前过日子的时候
Especially our fathers when we become a God-loving person
你其实就是给你的后代你的家庭最好最大的祝福
Then you are accumulating blessing for your descendants for your family
所以今天我们庆祝父亲节我们也愿意在祝福这里所有的父亲
So today when we are celebrating Father's Day
还有这些 fathers to be
And the fathers to be
你们从小年轻的时候就好好的开始敬虔爱主。
So from now, when you are at your younger age, that you train yourself to become a God-loving person.
会给你们的家庭，会给你们所有的后代带来无穷尽的祝福。
It will bring and continuously bring blessing to your family.
很多人昨天也去参加毕业典礼。
Yesterday, a lot of us attend a graduation ceremony, the commencement.
我们叫做2017年的这一个班，这个级啊。
We call it the class of 2017.
我们今天有差不多20左右的毕业生。
Today, in our church alone, we have about 20 graduates.
那你们在人生中走到一个阶段，结束了。
So, the current stage of your life has ended.
所以你们要开始一段新的一段旅程。
So now you're already to go into the next exploration.
在人生转折点的时候，你会碰到很多的彷徨和无奈。
In this turning point, you will face a lot of hardship, a lot of misunderstanding.
无奈是，无奈，无奈。
Feeling of powerless.
Yeah, powerless. Yes, that's good. 所以你们会常常觉得会很彷徨啊。
So oftentimes you don't know what to do.
啊，到底什么回事啊？上帝在不在？等等。
You will think about what's going on and where is God.
所以我们今天就来先谈一谈两个字。
So today we'll talk about two words first.
Yeah, 我从圣经的角度来看，或从我们人的角度来思想一下两个字。
From the aspect of Bible.
第一个字是 graduation.
But the first word is graduation.
第二个字是 commencement.
The second word is commencement.
这两个字有什么差别？
So what's the difference between graduation and commencement?
这两个有什么差别？
What's the difference?
啊，这个中文都翻毕业了哈，就没有什么，没有太多好讲。什么叫 graduation?
So, what's the meaning of graduation?
什么叫做 commencement?
What's the meaning of commencement?
Commencement 大家都很知道，哎呀，也是一个新的开始啦，哈，很正式的场合，毕业典礼叫 commencement， 像我们昨天。
It's a very formal occasion, and at the start of a new start, then you call it commencement.
好，那我们也讲啊，这个人 graduate， 这个人毕业了。
And sometimes we refer this person as a graduate.
啊，这个字在过去几个礼拜一直在我心里面中想，我就自己稍微思想一下，我跟各位分享一下。
So last few weeks, this word, these two words has been like a rolling in my mind.
这个 graduate 这个字是从 graduate 来的，对不对？
So graduation comes from graduate.
然后 graduate 就是像有一格一格，一格有一个进程，哈。
So graduate, it's like,The graduate cylinder that you have different mark.
你就把我先用了，我还没讲 graduate cylinder， 他已经先用了。Exactly what I have in mind. You know, graduate cylinder 就是一格一格，有一个毫升、两毫升 graduate slowly filled up.
So graduate cylinder is like you have different marks on the cylinder that it's mark each individual volume.
所以你说我们 graduate 是什么意思呢？
So how, what's the meaning of graduate?
就是我们这个 graduate cylinder 满了。
So that's, is it meaning that the graduate cylinder is full now?
你好像就倒水在这 graduate cylinder 里面，慢慢慢慢就满了。
It's just like you accumulating waters in the graduate cylinder.
达到一定的标准。
So to fulfill a certain qualification requirement.
所以你在 OSU 开始注册。
So therefore, that you start your class at.
你从一字头开始上，二字头、三字头、四字头，对不对？
From the class of 100 level to 200 level, 300 level, 400 level, maybe slash course.
所以你付了代价，也许是 A， 也许是 B， 也许是哎呀刚刚好 C pass.
You pay the price and you get your grade.
它有标准的啊，你过了那个标准，就算你完成了这个任务。
So there are a lot of requirements. Once you fulfill those requirements, that you count it as.
好了，所以你 accumulate 你的 credits， 对不对？
You're accumulating your
学分啊，你的学分达到了一定程度，这个现在是多少毕业？
不知道，
你不知道，博士多少？90吧？
108。
哦，108。好，我达到108了。
So just like finish your PhD program, that you need 108 credits.
你把这108个都 fulfill 了。
So when you fulfill this 108 credit,
你完成了，达到它目标了。
When you finish.
You graduate.
Then you graduate.
对不对？所以这 graduate 是基本上它的精神是什么？是往后看，往以前看。
以前。So the meaning of graduate, sometimes it also refers that you have to look back.
哇，这是我自己的 interpretation 啊。
It's my own interpretation.
你就看到你的累积到了一定的程度了。
And you can see that your accumulation is to a certain point.
好了，我满足了这些要求，所以我毕业了。
Now I have fulfilled all my requirements. I'm graduated.
所以不管小学也好，初中也好，高中、大学，你到 graduate 的时候，你是往后看。Oh, I'm glad I did all this. I graduated. 我毕业了，完成了，有这个味道在里面。
It doesn't matter elementary school, high school, or college. And when you finish the requirement, you look back and say, I'm so glad that I have done that.
那 commencement 是什么意思呢？
So what's the meaning of commencement?
Commence 是一个开始的意思。
Commence is the meaning of new beginning.
啊、是一个新的重新的一个起头
New beginning
为什么 graduation 又叫做 commencement
Why graduation called commencement
我觉得 commencement 在这里对我来讲就是往前看的意思
So to me commencement is meaning that you have to look forward
就是说你过去完成了你的 quota 也好你的 criteria 你的这个 credit 都好了
It doesn't matter if you have finished your credit, your quota in the before.
但是你要往前看。
But what's more important that you have to look forward?
一个新的开始。
A new beginning.
一个不知道的未来。
An unknown future.
所以你在 graduate 跟 commence 两个字摆在一起的时候。
So when you put two words together.
我自己觉得有一个很大的差别。
I think that's one big difference.
就是一个看法或者一个心态上的差别。
It's from your perspective, it's from your viewpoint.
好，有很多人他很 proud of 他今天从 OSU 毕业 which
Many of you may be proud of like, you graduate from OSU
好或者是我们有些人 很 proud of 如果是 MIT、啊、或者是哪个更好 Harvard 啊 Stanford 毕业的话
Some of you may be even prouder if you graduated from Stanford or MIT
你更会跟别人讲 I graduated from Stanford、
you would tell others that you graduated from Stanford
Yo, I'm a Harvard graduate、
and you may refer yourself as Harvard graduate
都是往以前看
You lookon your back, on your past.
他往过去的历史看。
On your past history.
I graduate.
And you often say, I graduate.
但是在 commencement 上面你就没有后面了。
But in the commencement that you have no way to look back.
不管你有什么样光荣的过去。
It doesn't matter what kind of glory history that you have in the past.
每一个人都是有一个新的开始。
Everybody needs a new start.
我自己认为我们的态度应该从 commencement 这个角度来看是比较健康的。
I personally think that our attitude should look at commencement.
圣经里面讲了一句很重要的话。
In Bible, that's a very important verse.
忘记背后努力面前的。
Forget your past and work on present.
我们常常喜欢回去当年的英勇。
So oftentimes we like to refer our past history, our glory history.
想当年我也如何如何。
One would often say, when I was younger.
当年又怎么样?
When I was younger, so what?
你今年又怎么样?
So what? So what? What's your present situation?
我们常常活在过去里面，我自己认为不是对我们有什么好处。
Oftentimes I think that living the history, even the past, is not a very good attitude.
我记得在过去也跟各位讲过这件事情，好的跟坏的都要忘记。
So I think I mentioned this to you once at least. It's forget those bad and also forget those good.
你们昨天很开心，戴了这个方帽子，哎呀，高兴一天就好了。
So I know you guys are very proud and very happy yesterday, like wearing gown and all those stuff, but only for one day, remember.
好了，今天开始你们面对新的人生，忘记过去。
So from today, that you are facing a brand new future now. Forget your past.
Yeah, 我们过去不管是成功也好，失败也好，圣经教导我们，就把它忘去。
It doesn't matter it's successful, whether it's successful or not.That you have to forget your past.
因为圣经又有说了一句话。
Because in Bible, there's also another verse.
若有人在基督里，他就是新造的人，就是已过，一切都变成新的了。
If there's anyone who's in Christ, then he's a new being, and everything on the past has passed, and he's a new being now.
每一天，你都要面对一个新的一天，新的挑战。
So every day you are facing a brand new future and also a brand new challenge.
不要让过去成为你的包袱，好的坏的都是一样。
Don't let your past linger around and become your burden.
神给我们的恩典是够今天用，不是明天，也不是昨天。
God's grace to us is enough for us today and also to our future.
所以从过这个 graduate 到 commence， 我自己认为心态上还有一个很重要的因素。
So I personally believe the differences between graduation and commencement, it's your attitude.
这个我也是愿意送给所有的毕业生哈。
And would like to give this to all graduates.
如果我能送你们一件最大的礼物。
If I can give you one big present.
最有用的礼物。
The most useful present.
And I guarantee it works 的礼物。
and a present that I guarantee it will work.
我给你们两个字，谦卑。
I give you two words. Not one word.
In English.
English. Humility.
啊，这个谦卑我觉得是世界上最重要的事情。
I think that's the most important thing in this world.
你再好的 graduate, GPA 3.99, 回过头来看你前面的时候，你的 GPA 是从零开始的。
So it doesn't matter how high your GPA is during your college time, that you look at your future, yet your GPA is starting from zero.
我们每一个人在神面前，我都需要有这个 capacity， 就是谦卑。
Every one of us need this capacity.
如果没有这 capacity， 我自己敢保证你的成功会很光辉，但是不会长久。
If you don't have this capacity, I can guarantee you that your successful may be gory, but it won't last very long.
每一个人在神面前，那个 capacity 就是我们的谦卑。
So every one of us, our capacity before God, it's our humility.
我们人有时候骄傲的可怜哈。
We are pride. We human are often too pride to even pitiful.
Yeah, very pitiful. 我们很 foolish 的，我们会骄傲。
We are very foolish that we have such pride.
我们以为我们知道了什么。
We thought that we know something.
通常你回头看什么？哎呀，我知道 science 101从到592啊 whatever 哈。
So maybe you know science 101 to science 559.
我回过头看是我通常我会骄傲，你看我过去的成就。
So when I look back, I often will be very proud of myself. Look at what I have done.
当一个人骄傲的时候，他的这个 capacity 不大，而且是满的时候，新的东西、新的恩典进不来的。
When your capacity is occupied by such thing that no new things can come into you.
所以我们要大的时候，我们要倒空自己，是要谦卑的时候，那个容量就大，有容乃大，上帝的恩典福气就能够临到我们。
We need to empty ourselves to enlarge our capacity.
一定要有一个谦卑的态度，面对所有的事情。
You must have a humility, to all things.
很多人骄傲的可怜。
So all of us, like a lot of us, oftentimes we are too proud to even pitiful.
比如说我有一个亲戚啊，他是法学院刚刚毕业的，哎，我就拿我自己当律师来，你看我都懂。
I have a relative who's just graduated from law school, and he or her already considers herself.himself a lawyer.
哎呀，我一个亲戚或者是一个朋友，他念过一点医学。哎呀，我就是以名医自称，啊，很可怜的。
For example, I have a friend who just graduated from medical school, and he or she already conceived himself or herself a doctor.
因为人的骄傲真的是无止境的，我常常发现。
Because our pride has no limit.
当一个人真的知道在一个领域知道一点东西的时候，他真的懂一点的时候，他会发现他不懂得更多更多啊。
When someone truly knew something in the field, that he would realize that the unknown in his field is usually even more.
只有我们往回头看的时候，哎呀，我的好满好满，好棒好棒，好多好多。但是往前看的时候，你会发现你一无所知。
Oftentimes, when you look back, you were thinking that I'm so proud of myself, I accomplished all these things. But when you look forward, that you will realize that you actually have nothing.
一个态度上，一个谦卑的态度，就是从一个 graduation 到 commencement， 需要有这个态度在你心中。我真的是能够谦卑，好好学习，这样子是一个成功的人。
From graduation to commencement.There's another attitude that you should keep in mind. That's a humble attitude.
所以我给各位两个建议。
So two suggestions.
对所有的 毕业生来讲
to all graduates,
忘记背后努力面前的
forget your past and work on your future,
好的坏的都放下好吗
forget the good things and also the bad things,
然后把刻意在主面前谦卑自己
and then you need to humble yourself,
enlarge 你的 capacity,
enlarge your capacity,
这个是一个谦卑的概念是一个这个容量的概念
that's the concept of a volume, a capacity,
一个谦卑的态度面对你前面的人生
to have your humble attitude towards your future life
好这个是给各位毕业生讲的
to all graduates
然后呢第二点我是要跟所有人讲的
then to all of us
啊，也包括所有的爸爸们、啊、
including
祖父们等等
fathers、grandfathers
好这个经文在你们的 bulletin 上给你们拿出来看一看
so this scripture will be in your bulletin
好这段圣经是出自在这个、传道书、啊、
so this verse is from Ecclesiastes
OK 好我们来念一遍好吗我中间跳了第三节到第八节因为都很多重复、啊、我就跳掉
let's read it together
好吗我们 就来念一遍好预备来凡事都有定期天下万物都有定时生有时死有时栽种有时拔出手栽种的也有时这样看来做事的人在他的劳碌中有什么益处呢我见神叫世人劳苦使他们在其中受经历神造万物各按其时成为美好又将永生安置在世人心里然而神从始终的作为人不能参透这段事件非常 有算是很大家都耳熟能详的一段经文
I think many of you may have heard of it
然后我们常常说、timing 神做事有时
You often say timing and God has its own timing
好我们先来讲一下、前面这一部分
The first
一到二节
half of this verse
他说凡事都有定期
For everything, there is an appointed time.
事情有定时，万物都有定时。
So everything has its appointed time.
任何时候都有时间的。
So there is an appropriate time for every activity on earth.
好，这一段如果我们多念几次的话
You read it a few more times.
特别是把第三节到第八节都念一遍的时候
Especially from verse 3 to 8.
你会听起来，哎呀，这个人怎么说这么宿命论啊
？So you may say that these people believe in destiny.
啊，或者宿命论，或者叫做fatalism， 就是
fatalism.
呀，就是一个宿命论，就是反正一切都定了啊。
So that means that refers that everything has set up.
啊，已经我生下来有时死也有时，反正都已经定了，那我就躺着干好了嘛，是不是、啊、
？So you may think that everything has set up in my life that I don't have to work hard to get.
那这个后面的意思不是这样子的。
So it actually don't mean that. Doesn't mean.
他告诉我们一件很重要的事实。
So from this verse that we can see a very important fact.
所有的事情，天下事情都在上帝的掌握当中。
So everything.In this world, it's under God's control.
对，上帝有百分之百的控制在掌管掌权。
God has 100% authority on everything in this world.
从所有的圣经，所有我们的听到的教导，都是讲到一件事情：上帝坐着为王，他永远是不会错的。
God sit in His throne, and He will never make mistake.
我们的生人生好像一本打开的书在上帝面前什么时候生什么时候死中间发生什么事情早已经上帝都知道了
So our life is like an open book to God's eye
好那我们就说好了那反正既然这样那我们就躺着干嘛反正天饼馅饼会从天上掉下来
Oftentimes if you take it to the extreme that you would think that God has control everything that I don't have to do anything
这句话没有错
There is nothing wrong with this word
百分之百的对
100% right
但是
But,
这个不是全部的真理
But that's not 100% of the truth
Yeah, the truth 包括这个
The truth includes
还有包括另外一个百分之百
There's another 100%
另外的百分之百在这里没有讲
It didn't mention in here another 100%
在其他圣经里面讲得很清楚
But it has referred in other verses of the Bible
这一句是对的
That is very true.
另外一个百分之百是什么呢
What is the other 100%?
就是你我完完全全百分之百决定你我将来的命运或者是去向
Then you control your future destination 100%.
好，再听一次哈。我们每一个人 individually, you decide 你自己的 destiny 100%.
So we, us as individual, we control our destination 100%.
上帝从来不会勉强任何人做任何事情。
God will not force you to do anything.
让我们有自己的选择。
And let us to have our own choice here.
我们对自己有百分之百的控制。
So we have 100% control of our life.
仅此而已。
Only that.
对别人没有。
Does not include others.
懂吗？这个非常重要的真理。
That's a very important truth as well.
我要对我自己完完全全的负我的责任。
I need to take my responsibility.
不是我的父母要负我的责任，不是的。
This responsibility doesn't hold in your parents.
不是我的妻子，不是我的丈夫负我责任，不是的。
Doesn't hold in your
spouse hand. 也不是牧师要负我的责任，不是的。
Does not hold in
每一个人在上帝面前交自己的账。
You need to pay your own debt before God.
啊，不要管 debt 哈，我们也 account. We have
account. You need to account.
有 credit 也有 debt, OK.
You need to account yourself before God.
每一个人在上帝面前交自己的账。One individual, that's it.
You, as an individual, that you account for yourself 100% before God.
所以我自己认为全部的真理包含两部分。
So I personally believe that the truth contains two halves.
上帝百分之百的决定。
God 100% decides.
但是你自己。你决定你自己。
And then you also have your own decision.
这才是全备的真理。
Where you are going.
在这个地方只讲到前面这一部分。
So in this verse, it only mentioned the first half.
所有的事情都在上帝的安排当中。
So everything God has, is under God's control.
你我一个人在这个整个世界的下面里面，你有你的决定权，我有我的决定权。
So you has your own decision and I has mine.
我们个人要为自己的将来。负上完全的责任。
We need to take responsibility for our future.
好，这个地方就讲到前半。
So in here, it only mentioned the first half.
在讲下半前，我先把里面一个字，我要先提出来。
And before I mention the rest of the verses, and I put up one word first.
这个字非常的有意思。
And that's very important and very interesting word.
好，中文翻成永生。
And
中文翻成。Eternity.
In Chinese, it translates as eternity.
但是英文哈 ，NET version 翻成 ignorance.
But in MET, English version, it translates as ignorance.
有些如果你们看 NIV 的话，它翻译 eternity or future days, whatever, 哈。
But if you see another version of the Bible, it often refers as eternity or future days.
好，我就很简单的讲一下哈，他们这里面的这个 word study 是怎么样。
So I mention it simply what the word study in here would be.
这个原文它是这个旧约都是希伯来文，对不对
？So originally it's from Hebrew.
它那个字，它这个因为写的时候，有一部分的专家他就说很可能有一点点失误啊。
So many many experts in Bible
Bible theology. Bible scholar.
Bible scholar said there might be some mistake happened
when they copy.
Yeah, when they copy the Bible.
所以那个字应该是永生的意思，或者 future 的意思，是一个未知的意思。
So originally that word should mean a future or eternity.
但是如果是我们假设这个字没有错的话
But if you think that this word has no mistake.
在希伯来里面，原文是黑暗的意思。
In Hebrew, that it means darkness.
那黑暗就，上帝把黑暗放在人的心里，哈 ，doesn't make sense, right?
God put darkness in people's heart.
Okay, 那个黑暗
doesn't make sense.
黑暗不光是黑暗，它还有另外就是一个糊涂，或者说一个不懂，或者一个浑浊的状态。
So.In besides darkness, it also means confusions or misunderstanding.
Yeah, 或者就是 ignorance,
or
就是不知哈。
More clear ignorance.
Yeah, ignorance 就是说你在一个 obscure 这一个状态里面不清楚的状态里面。
So ignorance means that you are in the situation of obscure.
你们喜欢哪个
？What's your version? That what's the version that you may prefer?
我自己读读读到最后，我自己是认为 ignorance 是比较好，所以我才放上去嘛，哈，对不对？
So I, after read it so many times, I personally believe that the ignorance would be a more proper version.
Yeah,
that's why I put it here.
我比较喜欢 NET 啊，它是比较合乎我的口味啊。所以翻圣经哈，看读圣经很有意思哈。
So it's very interesting when you read the Bible.
他为什么把这些 ignorance, 把这些不知道的东西放在人心里面呢？
Why God would put ignorance in people's heart?
哎，这个又很有意思哈。
That's very interesting.
好，那我们来看看后面，又将，如果我们就把它一个无知或者是一个不清楚的状态放在人的心里面。
So it God put this ignorance in people's heart.
其实是很合乎他的讲法。
So it's actually very fits the letter of that sentences.
他说因为把这个无知或者是很迷糊或者一个不清楚的放在人心里面，所以人不能够参透神所有的作为。
So it reads like this, because God has put ignorance in human hearts, so people cannot discover what God has ordained.
不是神刻意的不给人，就是神 allow人不能够参透上帝所有的事情。
So God allowed this to happen. God allowed human to do not understand what God has ordained.
因为本来就是如此嘛。
Because that is the case.
我们人就是人嘛。
We are human.
我们不是上帝，我们怎么能够参透万事呢？
We are not God. How can we understand everything?
我们喜欢参透万事，但是我们不能够参透万事。
We would like to understand everything.
我们自己的事情我们都不明白。
Oftentimes,
我们怎么样参透万事呢？
You would not understand your own business.
所以我必须要讲，我自己觉得这样子讲是神给我们一个保护。
So God gave this protection to us.
我们不知道明天其实是对我们好的。
The reason that you don't know your future is because God's protection.
我们很多人喜欢去算命，喜欢去卜卦，是想知道明天。
Many of us would like to go to the fortune teller, and you would like to know something about your future.
很简单。
Why you want to know your future?
求福避祸嘛，不是就简单这样。
So you can avoid those misfortunes,
对不对？但是神不要我们这样子做。
But God doesn't allow us to do that.
神要我们信他，就是今天就信他。
God wants us to believe in him.
明天自有明天的忧虑，是神掌管明天。
So you would have your own worry tomorrow.
换句话说，神要我们努力现在的事情。
So in another words, that means God wants you to work on the things today.
努力面前的。
Work on your present.
不要为明日担忧，对不对？
Don't worry about tomorrow.
所以圣经里面有很多的话叫我们不要算卦，算就是这个算命等等，就是要保护我们，这个不是我们的范畴。
So that's why God put this restriction on fortune telling.
所以在这个地方说，上帝把 ignorance 放在我们的心里面，让我们对这些事情无知道，不懂，是保护我们。
Therefore in this verse, God mentioned that he put ignorance in human heart.
他要我们做的就是今天把你的责任做好，做上百分之百的努力。
So what he wants us to do is to work your 100% today.
所以我们之前在教会里面，我常常各位弟兄姐妹们交代。
So therefore in church, I often tell you guys,
基督徒不是坐在家里面等馅饼从天上掉下来，绝对不是。
Being a Christian doesn't mean that you sit in home waiting for fortune to happen.
我鼓励所有的人，
I encourage every one of us.
Work your butt off.
Work your butt off.
你好好的努力，尽你最大的努力。
Try your 100%.
把你所有吃奶的力气都使出来。
Spend every effort.
把你目前的工作做好。
To do 100% of your
present work. 这个是你的责任，百分之百。
So that's your 100%. That's your responsibility.
好，没完哈。
It hasn't finished yet.
好了，很多人尽了，我就抓着不放，我要这个，我要那个，你看我尽了全力了。
So many people work their 100% and they want they hold on to these things.
还有另外一个百分之百。
There's another 100%.
你做完你的百分之百，
after you finish your 100%,
你要放手也是百分之百。
You also need to 100% let go.
大部分人做不到。
Most of us cannot do that.
哎，我们做父母的对孩子放不了心。
Especially like parent.
从小就看到他念书。
So many of our parents are not willing to 100% let go of their children.
我们爱的爱的，心里面一块肉啊。
They're often treated as the most treasured things in our heart.
哦，上初中。
from high school.
上高中。
High,
上大学。
And then to college.
上研究所。
And then to grad school.
啊，他以后要这个找老婆啊，要
And then their
找老公啊，要他的孩子我还去管。
And also, I need to take care of their children.
什么都管。
And you, I need to take care of everything.
对不对啊？
True.
放不了手啊。
You cannot let go.
弟兄姊妹，就是要放手。
But brother, sister, I tell you, you need to let go.
刚刚生有时，死有时，就是要放手也有时啊。
So there's a time to be born, there's a time to die, but there's also time to let go.
尽了我们的本分。
You finish your 100%.
我们也要交给上帝百分之百。
Then you need to put, you need to give it to God 100%.
做得到吗？
Can you do that?
要做啊，你不做，为你会痛苦一辈子的。
I'm telling you that you need to do that. Otherwise, that you will be in agony.
我们一定要对所有的事情尽了力就放手。
Therefore, after we put on our 100% responsibility, we also need to let go.
这个就是安息日的由来。
That's the reason.
讲过哈，我已经讲过。
Sabbatical.
对，什么叫就是这个安息日？就是安息是怎么样？你要放手就是安息。
So what's the meaning of sabbatical? That means you need to let go.
天塌下来，让上帝去顶，这个叫做安息，懂吗？
Anything happen, let God handle it.
所以对我们来讲是有益处的。神把这个无知放在我们心里面，是对我们一个保护。
So God put this ignorance in our heart. It's the protection to us.
要我们尽上我们百分之百的努力。
So we need to put on our 100%
responsibility. 百分之百的放手。
Then we also need to let go 100%.
在这种情况之下，我们就能够得到安息，要不然没有安息可言。
In this situation that we can have sabbatical.
好，然后我们 讲下面。
So, then we will continue to talk about this verse.
这样看来，做事的人在他劳碌中有什么益处呢？
What benefit can a worker gain from his toil?
哦，我看见神叫世人劳苦，使他们在其中得经验。
I have observed the burden that God has given to people to keep them occupied.
神对他的孩子不是溺爱。
God would not spoil his children.
我们看不惯我们的孩子受苦。
So we cannot,
对不对?
We cannot see that our children suffer.
我们做父母的，我们爱我们的孩子，爱到一个程度，我们看不下去他受苦啊。
So we as parents, we love our children to a degree that we would not let them to suffer.
什么都给他弄最好的。
We prepare everything the best for them.
什么都给他找最好的。
Everything we prepare the best for them.
哎呀，为他预备所有所有的都是最好的。
Everything that he has and he will be using.
他不能够受伤，不能够吃苦，你他吃苦，你要抢替他出头啊。
So cannot be suffer. He cannot be injured.
我自己认为这个不是一个好的教导。
But I personally believe that's not a good way to teach your children.
孩子需要吃苦，就该让他吃苦。
If he need to suffer, let him suffer.
在其中受经炼是什么意思呢？经炼什么意思？
So what's the meaning of occupy?
他要在痛苦中，在难处里面长大出来，那才是他的东西，不是你的东西。
He need to grow up from the suffer, from the hardship.
有的时候我们做父母要心一横，就让孩子去受吃苦。你做得到吗？
We as parents, sometimes we need to let our children suffer.
不要什么事情都给他准备得好好的。
Do not prepare everything for them.
上帝看得起我们，看得下我们吃苦，我们也应该看得下我们的孩子吃苦。
It God allow us to be occupied by such thing that we need to let our children suffer.
因为只溺爱的一个做父母
as well.
不是一个好父母，你教不出一个好孩子来。
Do not spoil your kids.
我们在日生活中吃苦，是为了我们的好处。
So we have this, we occupied by such thing is for our benefit.
好，我们今天有 Isaac 在这边，他是做 intern.
So Isaac here, he's going to intern.
他这边在两个月，他会不会说，我在这边要吃好的，穿好的，我要享受所有的人生啊，在 Corvallis.
So Isaac will only be here for 2 months. Would he say
会不会
that I want to enjoy my true life in Corvallis?
你的 intern 只是暂时的。
Your intern's only temporarily.
练习一下而已。
It's for your practice.
你的目标是什么？就放在一个 permanent job, a good one, 对，对不对？
So what's your goal? You want to find a permanent job.
你要一个好的工作，你要在 intern 的时候就有一些 sacrifice. No big deal.
You need to sacrifice during your intern.
你好好的在 intern 的时候，你就操练一下，对你将来是有好处的。
You practice yourself during your intern is benefit for your future.
我们在世界上不过是一个实习生的生活。
We are merely intern in this world.
我很相信，很相信，我们将来有一天到天上，那个才是 permanent job.
I believe one day that we enter heaven, that will be our permanent job.
我们现在在世界上六七十年、七八十年，我希望有一百年哈，不过是暂时的。
So nowadays, we in this world, we may have 60 years, 70 years, or maybe even 100 years.
赶快学一学啊，不过一百年嘛。
But that's merely temporarily. That's merely intern.
你经历了，学了以后，到天上那才是。真正的工作开始。
Learn during this time, and your permanent job is in heaven.
我不认为到天上我们在那边弹诗歌，哦 ，praise the Lord, 赞美神。不是，我不认为是这样子。
I don't think the only job that we go into heaven is to praise the Lord.
我们今天在世界上没有公平，对不对
？So in this world, now we're feeling that there's no fairness in this world.
真的没有 fairness。
There's no fairness.
但是上帝有 fairness.
But God has fairness.
当我们受训完毕，每一个人在不同的地方受训。
When we train ourselves, when we finish our training,
上帝是百分之百的 equal opportunity employer.
God is 100% equal opportunity employer.
你不管在世界上你怎么样受训，你到将来天上，我们都有同等的机会。
It doesn't matter how you train yourself during this world.In heaven, that you will have the equal opportunity.
因此，我们不要计较在世界上，好不好
？So do not count what's happening.
不要把 internship 当做 permanent job.
Don't treat your internship as a permanent job.
我们不过是受个历练而已。
We are here to keep ourselves occupied.
我们不过是受煎熬，是让我们成为更有基督耶稣的样式的人。
So
不过如此啊。
Suffer.These hardship, this bad thing, or this training is only to let us more like Jesus Christ.
把我们的希望放在永恒，而不要放在现在。
Put your hope in the eternity, but not now.
如果 Isaac 在这个地方吃喝快乐，好好的 intern 两个月，保证他学不到东西。
If Isaac enjoy himself for this 2 months during in here, like going party every day,
反正是 intern， 我躺着干。
And then he would not learn anything.
他不会有好结果的。
He would not have any good training.
我们帮求神帮助我们，知道我们在这个世界上不过是一个暂时的经历而已啊。
May God help us to let us realize that we are merely temporary intern in this world.
然后最重要的是什么
？So what's more important?
最重要的是什么
？What's more important?
神造万物。个案其实成为美好。
The most important thing, God has made everything fit beautifully in its appropriate time.
他控制整个世界。
He controls the whole world.
你控制你自己。
You control yourself.
但是他 make it all possible, 让你我得到最大的操练和好处。
But he make it all possible.
这个就是你我的信心。
That is our faith.
我信他。会对我有最好的安排。
I believe in him that he will make the best arrangement.
只要我肯努力。
As long as I work hard.
只要我尽上我自己的本分。
As long as I pay my 100% responsibility.
上帝一定不会亏待我。
And God will treat me good.
他的公义就在这个时候彰显，绝对不会少我一分钱。
That's his righteousness.
他绝对绝对公义，他不能够不公义。
He will not be.Unjustified.
他让所有的事情成为美好。
He made everything fit beautifully in its appropriate time.
你想不想
？Do you like that?
我很想。
I want it very much.
我赶快到天上，这是我巴不得的事情。
I want to go.
留在地上是为教会啊！
I remain in this world is for the church.
没有其他目的，我在那里一定是好的无比的。
So in heaven, I believe there's all good.
上帝绝对公平，绝对对我们每一个人有最好的安排。
God is 100% fair, and He has best arrangement to all of us.
好，结论，给所有的父亲和毕业生。
To all fathers and graduates.
我们开始一个新的人生，好吗
？To start a new life journey.
Humility.
But most importantly, remember humility.
This is the gift I presented to you all.
这个是我给大家的礼物。
你们一定要谦卑啊。
You need to be a humble one.
初中毕业也好，你不要认为我很棒啊，我初中毕业啦。
Even include those who graduated from high
school. 高中毕业，大学更了不起哦，博士哦。
Including those PhD.
Zero 开始。
But you need to start from zero.
你从你的 capacity 要放大。
From your capacity, you need to enlarge yourself.
一定要在神面前谦卑自己啊。
You need to humble yourself before God.
好不好？忘记背后啊
！Forget your past。
不管你从哪里毕业，名牌 OSU 毕业啊。
Even you are graduated from OSU。
忘记它。
Forget about it。
从零开始。
Starting from zero。
好好谦谦卑卑的，你忘记背后，努力面前。
So forget what is behind。
然后再信靠上帝，在我们人生中一定有一个好的安排。
And also, you need to believe in God that He has the best arrangement in your life.
他的时间才是时间。
His appointed time.
我们常常说，哇 ，where, when, how 等等哈。
We often ask God when, how, what.
哎呀，你做好你的事情。
Do your responsibility.
交给他。
And let go, let Him in charge of it.
你只要问一件事情就行了。你有没有尽上你百分之百的努力
？Ask one thing.Have you finished your 100% responsibility?
他做事有定时。
He has its appointed time. He has his appointed time.
你们有找到事的，还在工作的，还在考虑的，在迷惘的。我有一句话送给你们。
For those who are stumbled, who those who are still looking for a job, I have one word for you.
我们都是不知道剧本的演员。
We are all actors that doesn't know our plot.
The script,
a script.
我们的 plan, 我们真的不知道我们的下一个剧是什么一个场景，不知道。
We don't know what's the scenario of our next script.
但是上帝都知道。
But God knows.
剧本都写好了。
God knows every script.
你的责任就做好你的事，不要去做上帝的事，好不好？
Your responsibility is handle your own things. Do not worry about God's responsibility.
我们常常喜欢当上帝。哎，这个怎么样？哎，那个怎么样？我来指指点点。
So we often we like to play God and we need
to point
at others.
None of your 什么 business?
None of your
这是我的名言哈。None of your business. 去管上帝的事情好吗？
So it's none of your business. Let God handle His business.
Oh, good. 他已经讲出我下一句要讲了。Let God be God.
让神做神。
你做好你的事就好，好不好？
Mind your
business. 多管闲事。
Yeah.
管好你自己的事情。
Take care of your own business.
太多人自己是管不好，天天去管上帝的事情。
So many of us cannot take care of own business.
愚蠢啊！
But would like to involve in God's.
弟兄姊妹，我们管好自己的事情，把你分内的事情做好了。交给上帝，这个是我们应该做的。
Brother and sister, take care of your 100% responsibility.
做好，交托，这个是神的教导。
Do your 100% and also let go 100%.
好，你要专心仰赖耶和华。
So, in another word, trust in the Lord with all your heart.
不可依靠自己的聪明。
And do not rely on your own understanding.
求神帮助我们，让我们把他的把我们的心打开。
So may God help us to open our heart.
相信他。
Believe in him.
相信他对我们每一个人都有最好的计划。
Believe in him that he will have the best arrangement plan to all of us.
对所有的父亲 Happy Father's Day.
To all fathers, Happy Father's Day.
May you become the blessing, the source of your entire family.
愿你成为你家庭的祝福。
让每一个做父亲做祖父的成为你的 client 祝福的源头好吗？
So let your so may every father grandfather become the source of blessing of your client.
让所有的毕业生从今天开始好好的依靠上帝。
So blessing to all you graduates and starting from today rely on God.
相信上帝在你生命中一定有最好的安排。
Believe in God that God has best arrangement in your life.
忘记背后。
Forget what is behind.
努力面前的。
Work on what is present in front of you.
尽好你的自己的本分。
Do your 100% responsibility.
相信上帝会有最好的安排。
And believe in God that He will have the best arrangement for your life.
好，我们一起来祷告。
Let's pray together.
主，我们感谢你。
Lord, we thank you.
生有时，死有时。
There's a time to be born, there's a time to die.
栽种有时，拔出有时。
There's a time to plant, there's a time to harvest the plant.
我们世界不断的在循环，春夏秋冬。
This world is continue to cycling from winter to spring to spring to winter.
都有时啊。
But there's also its appointed time.
我们都有阶段性的任务。
We all have our mission in our stage of life.
但是主，你对我们每一个人都有一个很重要，每一个人都有不同的使命。
Lord, but you have given your mission to all of us.
帮助我们找到你创造我们的目的是什么。
Help us to understand. Help us to find out what's our mission in our life.
帮助我们的人生变成有意义。
Help us life to be meaningful.
让我们知道是为什么而活。
Let us to know what's why we are living.
不是过一些好日子而已。
Not just for the good life in this world.
不是只是为我自己着想。
Not just to think of ourselves.
乃是主啊，我们要找到那设计师当初的用意是什么。
Lord, we need to find the creator's design.
主啊，你帮助我们打开我们的心，打开我们的眼，让我们能够看到明白。
Lord, please help us open our eyes so we can understand.
听我们的祷告。
Listen to our prayers.
奉靠主耶稣的名。
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.